Hello everyone. Today our topic in sorting algorithms is bubble sort. Sorting is defined as the process of arranging array elements according to some criteria. For example, in an ascending or descending order. Bubble sort, or also called sinking sort, is the simplest sorting algorithm that works by repeatedly swapping the adjacent elements if they are in the wrong order. Given the unsorted array A, we start by comparing the first two adjacent elements, and if they are in the wrong position, we swap them. Next, we move to the next pair, etc. After completing this scan, we will have here the largest element in the array, but the array is not sorted yet. We start with the next scan, but now we do not need to consider this element. After completing the second scan, we'll have the second largest element here, or the largest among these elements. And again, in the next scan, we do not need to consider it. And this process is repeated until we are left with the first two remaining elements in the array. This means that in bubble sort, we need two nested loops. In the external loop for I, we need n iterations, and in the internal loop for j, we need n minus I minus 1 iterations. Suppose, for example, that we have the array elements 4, 9, 3, 8, 1. We start with 4 and 9. They are in their positions. Next, 9 and 3. We have to swap them. Next, 9 and 8. Again, we have to swap them. And the final comparison, 1 and 9. We have to swap them. We are completed with the first pass, and we have the largest element here. So in the next passes, we do not need to include it. Next, we start the second pass. We swap 4 and 3. Next, 4 and 8, they are in their positions. And the next comparison, 1 and 8, we have to swap them. Again, we have the largest value here, and we do not need to include it in the next passes. So we have here 8, 9, 3, 4, 1. We start the next pass. 3 and 4 are in their positions. 4 and 1, we have to swap them. And now again, we have here 4, and we do not need to consider it. The next passes, here pass 3. We start the last pass. Here we have 3 and 1, so we have to swap them. This is the last scan, and the array is sorted. Here is the Python code for the bubble sort. Given the array, n is the array length. We start the external loop for I in range n, and the internal loop ranging from 0 to n minus I minus 1. We compare array j with array j plus 1. If it's equal, then we swap these elements. Otherwise, we continue with the next j. After completing the internal loop, we again start the next external loop. The complexity of the bubble sort is big O n squared. The bubble sort can be optimized or improved as follows. Suppose in a certain pass or scan here, we do not perform any swap operation. In this case, we do not need to continue with other passes. If in the internal loop, we do not perform any swap operation, then we can break the program. To implement the optimized bubble sort, a Boolean variable, for example, swapped, is initialized to false before entering the internal or before starting each pass. If during a certain pass we perform a swap, then swap is switched to true. So before starting the next external loop, we check if start is false, then we are done and we can break the program and print the sorted array. Although the complexity in the optimized bubble sort is also big O in square, but in several cases, the array will be sorted without the need to perform unuseful passes and comparisons. For today, that's all. Thank you.